With increasing flooding across the country, change in seasons and prolonged droughts, Ugandans are slowly being forced to pay for their destruction of the environment and coming face to face with climate change challenges. Unfortunately, information obtained from the State Minister of Environment, Beatrice Anyual, indicates that efforts to remedy the situation have been stifled by political interference. She has accused the big shots in the government of wetland destruction, threatening to name and shame.
But as I said earlier, if we stop talking about the bad habits of these people, if we don't display them, maybe they're hiding and pretending. I'm reaching to tell you the truth. I'm very uncomfortable with this. Because you sit with the people who are punching you from behind. It's not nice. This is a fact. It's not nice. And we are not going to stop. So just watch the space.
For now, government has stopped issuance of licenses to investors to set up industries in wetlands. Planting of trees in wetlands has also been abolished as cancellation of land titles acquired in wetlands continues. Very soon, environment courts will start operating so as to help in handling case backlogs on the environment. Government is also set to embark on a campaign to restore all the destroyed forests, starting with compensation of people who are settled in the forest reserves legally.
Drivers is greed. Greed and getting rich very fast. I think that is the biggest challenge we are facing. The law must catch up with these people. If we start with about 10 of them, those who are sitting at the very high tables, by the way, it is not even the poor people who degrade the environment. For them, they just put manure and even maybe grow rice. But it is these ones who go at night and dump soil with big trucks to construct a building in a wetland is a very expensive venture. I just wonder. Until you see us trying to pull down some of these things, as we pray that also God helps us, like the other time people had to run away from the shores of Lake Victoria. It's a real challenge we have.
Minister Anyual disclosed that Uganda is among the countries to benefit from the Climate Finance Fund worth $100 million from the United Nations. Report by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.